Welcome back, everybody. CK here with AJR Racing. If you're new here, welcome. Folks, we got a Proto GT series we're going to do today at Road Atlanta. And if you follow the channel, you know that I love this track. So I'm super excited. We got almost 40 registered, so it's going to be a good one. But without further ado, let's get to it. All right, folks. Here we are for another multi-class race. The Proto GT series. Road Atlanta. Track temperature out there is 29 degrees Celsius. Winds coming out of the west at 4 kilometers an hour with a relative humidity of 53%. With a zero chance of rain. Today, folks, how are we doing out there? Qualified 7th. Not a very good qualifying, as usual. I had a good lap going, and I biffed it. Wow, that person sounded young.
Would you look, you guys?
Good luck, good luck. Have fun.
Yeah, this should be a good one, folks. Looking forward to this one. I figured the strength of field would be higher, but it is what it is.
The track temp is 29. The air temp is 19 Celsius. 30 minutes. Follow car number 12. Left lane. I swear that was a glitch in the game a little bit or something. Maybe I got some settings too high or something. I don't know. I got pink in front of me and pink behind me. And I got a Dunkin' Donuts car. Somebody okay,
went
jump,
way
stay
off.
Calm, focus. Let's go.
That stunk.
Left side. Clear left.
Dunkin' Donuts is gone.
Decent start. We can build something from here.
struggling for grip through there.
Whew.
I think we're pretty slotted in now. Go to work. This guy is slow.
P6. Nice move, mate.
Woo, come on. Let's go. Uh-oh.
Sorry, man.
All right, I should have a better graft here.
Far left. Clear left.
Chuck, nicely done.
Woo! Oh yeah.
The leader has just done 110.34. The car ahead has just done 110.73. P4.
Give it up.
Paul Taylor is hot on our tail.
The gap to Taylor behind is now 1.1.
Got a much lower downforce setup though.
Last lap time is at 110.49.
Putting some distance on Paul. Still doing good. We're gonna have to rely on lap traffic, hopefully, to get these guys closer in front of us. Hopefully it works for us and not for them.
The car in front has just done a 110.23. That's your quickest lap of this session. Sectors 1 and 3 are 0.34 off the pace. Sector 2 is 0.40 off the pace.
Struggling through there a little bit. These guys in front are just leaving us.
Stefan, go.
Again, a little sketchy through there.
I really need to get
past these guys. I'm not gonna either. You're caught. Dang it.
Clear right.
Oh, it's a terrible place. Let me by.
The gap to Taylor behind is now 2.7.
Yeah, these guys are way ahead of me now. Of course he has. It's smoking. It's a great pace.
That was a 112.34.
Transition.
P4.
Paul's hanging around. He's right there. It's not far off. 3 seconds. Time.
That's 20 minutes to go. 20 minutes.
Dude, why don't you go wide?
Clear right.
Got an in-class back marker here.
The gap to Taylor behind is now 2.9 seconds.
Got a bad feeling about this.
Killer driver on the passenger. Look good. Come on. You look patient.
Stay right.
Y'all are better than that. I know you are. I know you are.
On your left. Clear left.
Thank you.
Slower class car ahead.
I need to catch this vet. Come on. Not gonna get it. Dang it. That was close. Very stressful. Come on, let's go. Really wish I had 100 shot of nitrous right now. Need some sauce.
Behind is increasing. It's now 3.2.
Since my driving's garbage.
You've just done 111.42.
Someone's off. Saw smoke. Catch this Ford GT. Ah, it's a Dunkin' Donuts car.
Ain't to blame. I left you all the room on the outside, just turning in front of me. What to expect?
Slow car ahead.
Okay, Joe, brown moment.
15 minutes left, that's 15 minutes. Halfway home, fuel's good.
Woo! Taylor's still right there, hanging around. That's awesome. He's keeping me honest.
Far left. clear left. On your left, clear left.
All right, we made it through that. Woo! Gotta remember to upshift early back there.
Sector 1 is 1.3 off the pace. Sector 2 is 0.37 off the pace. Sector 3 time is fast. Alright, Chuck.
Someone's off. Oh boy.
The guy in front is Lockhart. Coming up on a slower class car.
Nice! Somebody's off. That's a freebie. I believe we're at podium now. Podium contention.
Just done it. 109.51.
Left side. Clear left.
Woo.
We like this. Keep doing it. P3. Up lap time was 111.00. Salotti in the gap to now, 4.9 seconds. Slower car ahead, this is their class leader.
Perfect timing. Oh. 1-800 protest. Did you see that on the back of his car? That was funny. All right, the rears are getting a little loose. Feeling hot. Couldn't have caught these guys in a worse spot.
Slower class car ahead. He's their class leader.
On your left. Clear left. Car left. Hold your line. Clear left.
Well done, Chuck. You're looking really good. Come on, keep your focus. You've got 10 minutes left, 10 minutes to go.
Darn it. Don't need any more off tracks. Guy's fast. Pray for a little lap traffic luck. Attempt 3. That's respectable. He was unhappy with something.
Okay.
Yeah, I need to stop before crashing the pit by someone.
Yeah, so Bortolotti ahead is now 5.4.
Bortolotti was very close to me on the side. He didn't let me go first, and that put me new to me.
I'm gonna catch this guy in a horrible spot again. Had to force the issue there. Come on, tires. Don't fail me now. It's getting a little slick back there.
The track temperature is increasing. It's now 31 Celsius.
Is just gone. It's incredible.
P3, your last lap time was at 11.01. Okay, Chuck, 10 minutes of fuel remaining. Bortolotti ahead is increasing. It's now 6.2.
Thirteenth and fourteenth are battling. It's going to make it hard to get through them. Appreciate the effort. Thank you.
Slower class car ahead.
Alright. We gotta catch this guy. Get out of my way, Schweitzer!
Bortolotti in front is now 7.1 seconds. Okay, Chuck, you're approaching some slower cars. These guys are fighting for position.
These guys are gonna hold me up too.
I'm that much past me.
Class fantastic. Good lap. 10-7.
He's in a 10th in sectors 2 and 3. Sector 1 is not a 8 off the pace.
Yeah, Jim, there's this little thing called traffic.
Coming up with some slower cars, they're class leaders in this group. 5 minutes of fuel remaining.
Left side. Clear left.
Nicely done, fellas. Been some great lap traffic in this race.
Thank you, Ian.
Slower class car ahead.
I thought that was Marco. Darn it. Woo.
Well done, Chuck. Great drive. That's a podium.
Woo! All right. Yeah. Super pumped about that. Oh, yeah. Good stuff, Maynard.
Yeah, I can't. I got damage. I've been trying. Trying to stay on racing.
Let's see. Oops. Here we go. Oh, I got a terrible start. My Dunkin' Donuts car got in front of me. This is going to slow us down.
Hopefully,
It was just going so slow. Like, look at this. Oh, and I blew it right there because I kind of followed him. Monkey see, monkey do. Yeah, I couldn't see. You can't see around a car when you're right there, so I thought he was online. And that's the longest time. He was gone. Oh, Kelly's behind me. What happens up here? Yeah, that was an exciting one. I recorded another one last night, and I got second. It was boring. There wasn't enough cars in it. There was only one other class car. I think it was a GT1 car, and that was it. So, yeah, it was, you know, big gaps in between us. So I had to do it again. Bring you a more exciting one. It's fun to watch. So then this guy is really slow too, it seemed like, at first. Oh, I snuck in there just right. Man, that was lucky. Yeah, I took advantage of that situation pretty good. Past Paul. Paul was actually, he had good pace for a while there. He was on us. He couldn't pull me in on the straights, though. That's so frustrating when that happens, but that's the price of ignition for medium downforce. But this time, I think we've already opened up a pretty substantial gap. I mean, not substantial, but, you know, it's a solid 3-4 seconds right there. Paul got through. Nice, Paul. I was worried it was going to be another lonely one, but it got exciting as soon as the lap traffic came. Guy didn't think I'd leave the space, I guess. Switzer. Yeah, he got scared. I don't blame him. Until you know how somebody's driving. It's the worst when you gotta come in here. So he didn't slow me down too bad. GT40. Oh, that's terrible. See, he's braking right there. You don't want to do that. should have just let me buy. Yeah. Should have just went through the car, honestly. Would have been so much better for me to just catch him on the straight. I was watching a Dave Cam video just today where it might have even been that same guy. I don't know, but I swear it was a guy in a blue Aston that did something similar. Yeah, it just slows us both down. And I caught this guy just about right. I had to go a little slow through there. Sir,
I know you are.
Ooh, there's a bit of battle going on here. Uh-oh, what's going to happen? Ooh, you got to leave the space, man. Come on. No good. Oh, well. Not the livery so much, but the car. I think I'm gonna buy that car next, honestly. I'm trying to figure it out this series. I'll just murder it out, too. Have the murder bet. Murder black. In case some of you don't know what murdered out means, it's all black. Let's speed this up. Let's get into the thick of it again.
Hold on.
What's this guy doing? He decides that he's going to make an inside move, then doesn't make the move. It slows way down too much.
Hold on.
Slows down way too much.
Hate to blame.
What about the Dunkin' Donuts guy? I think he's the same guy from earlier that wrecked. It is. Appreciate you letting me through, man. You didn't have to. Sorry, I had to force that move, buddy. That was a tough one.
Mate, I left you all the room on the outside and just turned in across me.
But really, I mean, he let me through just perfectly to where I could sneak in. He got right on me. That's a perfectly execution pass where Robin and I were on the same page. Because if we weren't, that would be wrong.
Mate, I left you all the room on the outside and just turned in across me. What'd you expect?
See who was talking here. Billy Wright. Can we find him? I should have just went the quick way, but I like to do things the hard way. What happens? Oh, it was a Metco. And, yeah. That's too bad. Seeing the guy reacted. That was a big net code too. Look at the gap in between there. That's not even close. That's, yeah. Oof, there's the contact. Right there, net code. It's almost a tire width apart. Ugh. Tough luck, guys.
Mate, I left you all the room on the outside. You just turned in across me. What do you expect?
Anything happen? Did we miss anything? No.
All right,
let's blaze forward here. This is the worst place to catch these guys, is right here. Sneak through there. I have to wait all the way until here to maybe move. Probably lost like half a second at least. But that's part of multi-class. That's what makes it exciting. That's what makes, you know, positions change all the time. I love it. Like, this is cool. Take this bad boy out. Split the pack there. That's a great view. Did these guys make it through all right? Let's see. That's a good racing going on back there. Okay, boys, well done. Oh yeah, what happened here? I think this is this was Dennis. He was in second. What happened, Dennis? Looks like the Aston lost it. Maybe no, he's getting out of the way. Oh man, what was that? You didn't see him. Wow. What the heck? What the heck was that? Will Schweitzer. What are you doing, man? You must not have seen him. Wow. To be fair, he didn't have him cleared when he... Jeez. That's almost, it's so suspect. I wonder if it must have been on purpose. Let's see Will's view. Will's coming over. Let's see, let's turn on the mirrors. Three. Hopefully that doesn't hurt performance too much. He's coming up. I mean, man, he's right there. How do you just... You hear him. Ooh. You know, in retrospect, to avoid this, I did it earlier, is I just stayed to this side very carefully to make sure. Until you hear the clear, you know? Because, he did not get clear yet. You know what I mean? Like, his crew chief did not call clear. He's still got overlap. He's right there. So that's when he comes over. Tap. It's like he didn't hit the GT car. The GT40. Such a shame. That's a tough one, Dennis. Sorry for the bad luck to both of you. But I would gladly scrape up that freebie. Perfect position. Didn't get slowed down there. This was good too. I got a good draft off of him. Got stuck behind these guys the worst time, and they're battling. 17th and 18th. Gotta respect their battle. It's almost harder to be the faster car. You have to go around everybody and predict what they're gonna do. Because really, ideally, if you're the slower class car, just stay on line. Unless there's a good spot to let somebody through, but you know, it's just going to be a better idea than do it, but...
That absolutely nuked me.
Uh-oh, somebody got nuked. Did we see it? Stefan, where you at? This guy? Was it? No. Wasn't this one, was it? Yeah, it's this guy. I don't know what this guy's doing. Like, he's driving. He's offline. He's going slow. Like,
no kill?
What are you doing?
Yeah, I need to stop. I got crashed in the pit by someone.
Guy's just got a drive through or what? Oh, wow. Wow. Seriously? Why wouldn't the slower car let him go? Wow, that's horrible, Larry. What are you doing? You let the faster car go. He's on the inside. And he's got overlap. Barely. Did you really think you were going to go too wide out of the pits? Come on, look at the lane assignments. It's 2-1. That. Now it's 1. Jeez. Wow.
Are you?
I believe that they're fighting for position too, because they're 33rd and 34th. So I don't know. That's just lack of experience. I don't know what you'd call that. Jeez.
Are you kidding me?
Brutal. You guys are both at fault there.
He nuked me.
Yeah. I mean, the GT40 must have got a drive through because his wing was still bent. Unless he just left the pits early, but. That's not smart. I think that's really it. Oh, then there's this guy again. He's just like, he's trying to facilitate a pass, but he doesn't realize that. Do what you're gonna do.
pitting out.
Yeah. It's Ian again. But he's here for safety rating.
Appreciate the effort. Thank you.
And damage pass me.
Oh, that's a slowdown. Three quarters there. Tight quarters. This is it. That's another thing too, when you pass somebody coming around, especially a slower car, you don't want to jump in front of them and hit the brakes. It's not a good idea. Because the car will stop as good, more than likely. Well, for sure, though, I haven't driven the other class cars yet. Actually, I take that back. I drove the Ford GT40. It was nightmarish to drive. I think I drove like an hour, hour and a half to Nordschleife to try and get it down, and I couldn't do a lap without wrecking. That was a fan request, too, and I just couldn't do it. I gave it an honest shot, though. Hey, laps are in this thing here. Do some chopper view.
Thank you, Ian.
Get to the chopper. I got a little too close to that dude for comfort. I gotta say. Didn't mean to. That could have been bad. Could have been a net code with us. Luckily, our connection was good.
Yeah, I can't. I got.
Yep, that's all she wrote. Let's check out the tail of the tape. All right, here we are looking at the tail of the tape and managed to get a very much needed positive 44 I rating. Brings us back up to a positive 3.5K and a positive 59 safety rating, 0.59 safety rating. Strength of field was 2.3K. It was only one split, but we had a ton of drivers. It was great. 39 drivers. Biggest gainer today was, who do we got? Looks like Jerome. Yep. Jerome Gruters. Division 3 guy. Well done, sir. Plus 63. Biggest loser in HPD was, ooh, triple digits here. Dennis Marco. Negative 142. That's one of the biggest losses I've seen. That's harsh to take. Better luck next time, buddy. See, biggest gainer in GT1 class was, looks like, Julian Beck. Well done, sir. Got a third place finish, positive 79 I rating, 126 champ points. Biggest loser in GT1, I think, was this guy right here. Nope, this guy, 78, negative 78, Josh Taylor. Yep. That's a tough one. Better luck next time. And I think, negative 10, positive 10 for the GT class, for GT, that is. But I hope you guys really enjoyed that one, and we'll see y'all at the next one.